Drive-By Movies. This is our brand new show, Direct to Dumpster. We're going to be talking about movies that you won't need to watch because we're going to lay it all out for you. These are old movies that are so bad, we had to watch them so you wouldn't have to. My name is Blaise.
And I am James.
Anyways, guys, our first movie of this series is going to be Bad Ronald. If you haven't heard about this movie, you're not the only one.
That sounds about right.
It sounds about right. It's a TV movie from the 70s. Very weird, interesting premise, similar to a movie that came out, I think, somewhat recently that you had seen.
Right, a movie that I think a lot of people still remember. It was called The Boy. Most people remember the plot twist to it, and that's what I like kind of mansplained to you, essentially. Just because like I was like, oh, it was actually a pretty cool twist. I didn't see it coming. But then the first thing you brought up was like, wait, there's a movie called Bad Ronald out there.
And I found out about this movie a while back, and it was something I'm like, oh, I have to watch. That's a really interesting premise. The premise is basically about this boy who's hiding within the walls of a house, and his mother kind of hid him into the house because he accidentally committed a murder.
Right.
Yes, it was an accident, but yeah. She wants to hide him, make sure that the cops can't find him, mm-hmm. and he's just going to live within the walls of the house. His mother then is, she's kind of sickly and does get ill, passed away, and now he's just in the walls of this house. It goes through escrow. Someone purchases the house and has Ronald just living within the walls. He sneaks out of his, like, he's hidden in kind of like a back room that they like walled off, and then it's like behind the pantry, so he sneaks out with throughout the night and like gets food, eats.
Yeah, I just want to know what the realtor was thinking though. Like, there's obviously blueprint models of this house. What's this big space that's missing in our home?
Oh, it's wonderful. I've never seen a house with such character before.
Oh, I admit it's a far cry from being immaculate, but it is a bargain.
Yes. Except for one thing, and I don't understand. Why would a four-bedroom house just have one bathroom? Doesn't make sense. I mean, I grant you, it's a large bathroom, but Mr. Roscoe with three daughters.
Bathrooms just weren't that important when the house was built.
That's what I want to know.
Big space behind the pantry, conveniently. You know, he comes out from time to time throughout the course of his time within the walls and like get some milk and cookie. Like, he's always, you always see him eating throughout the movie, like stuff where it's like, yeah, a teenager would eat that, but that is literally no nutritional value.
I don't, not even a teenager, sometimes like a little,
like a little 5-year old. Well, he's I mean,
that's what a little kid does when he's left home alone, like when he's pretending to be sick, like avoiding school.
Yeah, like, oh, mom, my temperature is 104.5. Oh, I think he'd be dead actually at that temperature. But and then he like just has milk and cookies the whole day.
Right.
But yeah. But anyways, I think his, you know, his developmental age is somewhat stunted by the fact that he had to stop immediately going to school. I think his mom did try and have him, you know, keep up with his books, keep up with his studies. But after she passes away, he's hopeless. He just keeps drawing. He's an artist, by the way. So if you're a nerdy kind of kid that's an artist, this is kind of what the movie's telling you.
Right,
like,
yeah.
Eventually you're going to go to jail. But yeah, it's like he's building this kind of like imaginary world. Like, he writes like stories
very thoroughly. Yeah. Thoroughly. He like creates his own world where like, or fantasy land, and forces it upon other people.
Yeah. Called Estrancia. And it definitely forces it upon other people. So Bad Ronald kind of like, you know, gets it. I guess he says like kind of obsessed. He's attracted with one of the daughters.
Right.
I don't even know if he differentiates between the three.
He thinks they're all part of his fantasy world, essentially. Yeah.
And he's going crazy within the walls. He just starts like drawing a Estrancia really like angrily and like going crazy. Because I mean, his only social interaction is, actually, he doesn't have any social.
It's just with himself and like the other people of Estrania, or whatever it is.
Yeah. Well, there's no one there. It's just like all in his head. He starts going crazy, essentially. I mean, he's like,
I think he was crazy before too.
He's like a horned up teenager, just hiding behind the walls. The only thing he has is this peephole to look through.
I'm glad his name is Ronald, though, not Brahms, like in The Boy, the movie that we're bringing up earlier.
Not a fan of the name, or
just Brahms is ridiculous. No, Bad Ronald, like, I'm like, Bad Ronald, bad dog and stuff.
Nothing's even like that bad about him until, like, I mean, he's just dealt a really shit hand. He gets mad at someone for, you know, making fun of his mom and then accidentally, you know, throws them on the ground.
You're weird, Ronald.
I am not weird.
Yes, you are. And so is your mother.
but they happen to hit a rock just perfectly placed in the back of their head.
Yeah.
And they die. Like that's
he's in the wrong, but his mom also was in the wrong for like thinking like, oh, well all right, never mind. He's a stupid idiot who decided to bury her and not
that we forgot about that. That's one of the biggest keys in the movie is he's like,
it's an accident. I found a shovel. And I buried her.
He gets home and he's like, Mom, yeah, I kind of killed someone and buried them as well. And his hands are all like muddy. It's like, oh no, there's DNA evidence everywhere.
It easily could have been an accident. And that's what it was, an accident.
But until you bury someone, I don't think it's an accident.
Right, yeah.
And that's the funny thing too is like, not only like, okay, he buried her, he's covered in mud, he comes home, and then like the cops do come by the next day.
Yeah.
But their questioning is just like, oh, the cops are like, where did he go? Yeah. Or like, we were looking for Ronald. We want a question. We heard he was at that pool party and then he's not there. Like, we want to see what happened.
Yeah.
Like, someone saw him and the girl and then like didn't see them.
Yeah.
You know? And then the mom's just like, oh, he disappeared.
Mm-hmm.
And then the cops are like, okay, well, let us know if he comes back. That's it. Like, it's so convenient that, and so obvious that he did it.
It's the 70s, man.
In the 70s, you could just disappear because there were no phones or anything. Right, I mean, there are phones, there are landlines, but there's no cell phone. So, like, you could literally just disappear.
Yeah, credit card tracking, that wasn't a thing yet.
Hitchhiking was popular.
Yeah.
That was a thing. I think that's probably one of my favorite parts of the movie is just how like everything gets so like it's probably like 10 minutes and everything just so gets so out of control. Like he just kills someone for making fun of his mom. Like
it escalates. Yeah.
You could definitely see yourself in his shoes.
Mm-hmm. Or I don't know about that, but
it's like, it's definitely very it's not unrealistic, but it's like, oh, whoa, this got out of control really quickly.
I feel like it was a tale also that's like kind of looking into the future. Like, this is what happens when you don't spank your kid.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he accidentally murders someone. He buries him. Like, oh, it's okay. You did nothing wrong. We'll figure it out from here.
Yeah. And the other thing is like the story picks up really quickly, but also it ends like extremely abruptly.
Right. Yeah.
Basically he busts out of the walls. Oh, that's another thing. He's very similar to like Bruce Banner's The Hulk. When he like throws that girl down onto the ground and kills her, like there's like a noise, like a sound effect where he's like, if you look at it, like he's like, and also her like head is just like, like, well, it's like almost like he's gonna crush it.
I read the director's note. He was telling him to go for a Lou Ferrigno. Persona right there.
Because like JK. he definitely throws her down like super strong, like weird strength.
The
like
people's a very elbow went down.
Special strength. Yeah. But then also when he busts out of the walls, it like goes slow and it's just like, like busts out of the wall. Like attacks like the girls, and then like somehow when he busts out of the wall, I'm sure the pantry wasn't right next to the front door or to like the house, but like he busts out of that and then also busts out of the front door and lands on the front lawn of the house.
Right. Yeah.
Like how much strength and speed did he pick up to get there that quickly? Yeah. And then the film goes slow-mo and he gets arrested immediately.
Just had that adrenaline rush,
And then it's that like fade to black and then it's the credits. And you're just like, I don't feel totally resolved. Like everything was resolved or I'm satisfied at all by any means.
I think ABC just kept telling them like, okay, all this stuff is good, but we really need to cut the end. We need to cut to commercial right now. I'm just assuming it was on ABC Family, even though it didn't exist.
That didn't exist at the time, but it's the equivalent of an ABC Family movie.
Right.
But the plot, I'll have to say, like, at least the story, I wouldn't say the plot, but the story was good enough. Like, what if someone lived in the walls within a house, but they just, like, squandered this beyond comparison.
So no one has capitalized on this concept yet. Yeah.
The concept of living within the walls of a house is very creepy. Very good concept.
Yeah.
This movie, I wouldn't say, nails it well. And I know you were talking about The Boy. Is that a movie that nailed it well?
No, not at all. Like, the ending, you're just like, oh, that's a cool ending. But the movie still sucked before it, though. Like, the first hour still is lame. And so this is a concept that's out there, just hasn't been capitalized.
So I'd say if you haven't seen this movie yet, I think it's available on YouTube. I could be wrong. Actually, no, it's not available on YouTube. But it's probably available somewhere online, because I doubt the rights, someone's still holding onto those Bad Ronald rights. I don't think, you know, anyone cares that much about it. It's, I would say, like, in the terms of movies that we'll be watching here on Directed Dumpster, this is probably a hidden gem. Yeah. Like, there's enough to laugh at while you're watching it, and there's enough, like, good story little nugget, but it's not a great movie, but it's not insanely boring. At least I'm, like, entertained watching it.
Yeah.
Especially with the nosy neighbor that's just there the whole movie. That is, like, the comic relief you need.
For me, I feel like there was just a tad too little comedic elements where it's so bad, it's good. I'd just say it's just like pretty much all bad. But the concept itself is such an interesting and different idea to where it does make it worth watching. Like, I highly recommend it. It is going to be entertaining to watch. You're just not going to get anything of it. I forgot about it literally after 30 minutes of watching it. Yes.
All right.
Yeah, it's that movie. But yeah, but it's a fun watch. It's a fun watch.
Yeah.
It's definitely belongs in the dumpster for me. But yeah.
Definitely. So anyways, guys, that's going to be it for the first episode of Directed Dumpster. Tune in next week and the weeks to come. We're going to be talking about other series, movies, TV movies, stuff that's been lost in that dumpster of VHS tapes, direct to DVD mishaps, asylum movies. I don't know. Whatever we find and brings our hearts content, we'll be reviewing here on Direct to Dumpster. Anyways, guys, that's Drive-By Movies. Tune in next week.